The United States has experimented with numerous advanced tank designs that were ultimately cancelled due to shifting military needs, budget constraints, or technological hurdles. These abandoned projects often showcased groundbreaking innovations far ahead of their time. Here's a comprehensive list of cancelled U.S. tanks and the stories behind their demise. The M1921 Medium Tank. The M1921 was one of the U.S. Army's first serious attempts at a medium tank following World War I. It was built in 1921 and armed with a 57mm gun and several machine guns protected by up to 25mm of armor. Weighing 23 tons and powered by a 220-horsepower engine. It suffered from poor mobility and mechanical reliability. The interwar period's limited military budget and changing doctrines led to its quick obsolescence. Only one prototype was ever built. The M6 Heavy Tank. Designed in 1940, the M6 carried a 76.2mm gun alongside a coaxial 37mm gun and had up to 83mm of armor protection. Despite weighing around 57 tons, it was still outclassed in mobility and practicality by medium tanks like the M4 Sherman. It faced significant mechanical issues and was considered too cumbersome for large-scale development. Only 40 units were built and never saw combat. The project was cancelled due to logistical drawbacks and lack of battlefield relevance. The T-20 Medium Tank. The T-20 series was designed in 1942 as a successor to the M4 Sherman, featuring a 76mm gun, torsion bar suspension, and improved transmission. The concept showed promise with advanced mobility and firepower for the time. However, ongoing success of the M4 and logistical concerns made its adoption unnecessary. Despite the innovation, no variant of the T-20 entered full production. The project was cancelled in favor of refining existing vehicles. The M7 Medium Tank. Originally developed in 1942 as a light tank, the M7 quickly grew in weight and size during development and ended up classed as a medium tank. It was armed with a 75mm gun and had armor up to 64mm thick. Unfortunately, by the time it was complete, it offered no real advantage over the M4 Sherman and was heavier than intended. The US Army lost interest due to better alternatives already in service. Only 13 were built. It was cancelled due to underperformance and redundancy. The T-14 Heavy Tank. The T-14 was a joint U.S.-British heavy tank project initiated in 1942 during World War II. It was designed to combine heavy armor and firepower, using a 75mm gun and up to 133mm of frontal armor. However, by the time the prototype was ready, the M4 Sherman had proven itself and production of the T-14 was deemed unnecessary. The tank was too heavy for its intended mobility and couldn't offer much more than existing designs. Only one prototype was completed. The T-34 Heavy Tank. Developed in 1945 near the end of World War II, the T-34 was a derivative of the T-29 T-30 Heavy Tank line, fitted with a powerful 120mm T-53 gun. It featured extremely thick armor, having 228mm frontal armor. Despite its impressive firepower, the tank was ultimately deemed unnecessary after the war ended. Its 65-ton weight combined with the logistical difficulty made it impractical in the evolving Cold War landscape. The project was cancelled with only two prototypes completed. The T-28 Super Heavy Tank. The T-28 was conceived in 1945 to breach German fortifications like the Siegfried Line, featuring extreme frontal armor up to 305mm and a powerful 105mm T5E1 gun. Its immense weight and slow speed made it unsuitable for most combat roles, especially as World War II ended before it could be used. The vehicle's design reflected an overemphasis on survivability at the cost of practicality. Only two prototypes were built. The T-42 Medium Tank. The T-42 was an early Cold War medium tank designed in 1948, equipped with a 90mm gun and armor similar to the M46. It attempted to modernize US tank forces, but ultimately failed to outperform the M48 Patton, which had already entered production. The T-42 also suffered from engine and mobility problems during testing. Only mock-ups and test beds were completed. The tank was cancelled in favor of better performing platforms. The T-57 Heavy Tank. The T-57 was developed in 1951 to explore the use of oscillating turrets and autoloaders in heavy tanks, mounting a 120mm gun for superior firepower. Its turret design was innovative, but mechanically complex and prone to failure. Though the tank had protection comparable to the M103 Heavy Tank, it struggled with reliability and maintainability. As a result, only a mock-up and test rigs were completed. It was cancelled before any full prototypes were fielded. The T-54. Not to be confused with the Soviet tank of the same name, the American T-54 was designed in 1951 as a test bed for a 105mm tank gun. It was intended to explore future heavy tank configurations, but suffered from poor performance and low mechanical reliability. The tank's armor was up to 127mm thick, and its weight hovered around 50 tons. It was envisioned as a bridge between the M103 and next-generation platforms, but it failed to meet expectations. After disappointing tests, the tank was cancelled. The T-92 Light Tank. Designed in 1954, the T-92 was a lightweight tank intended for airborne and reconnaissance operations. Armed with a 76mm gun and featuring a very low profile, it prioritized air mobility and speed over protection. It used aluminum armor, which made it vulnerable to heavy weapons but easier to transport. Despite promising trials, it was ultimately cancelled in favor of the M551 Sheridan, which offered missile capabilities. The T-92's low silhouette and the rear engine design were considered quite modern. The T-69 Tank. The T-69 was an experimental medium tank developed around 1955 with a 90mm gun. It sought to increase the rate of fire and reduce crew size using innovative European-style turret design. However, the complex autoloader system proved unreliable in testing. Armor protection was on par with the M48 Patton, but overall combat value was not superior. Project was cancelled in favor of simpler, proven designs. Only one prototype was built. The MBT-70. This was an American-West-German cancelled joint project to develop a new main battle tank during the 1960s. With a 152mm gun launcher for shell-lack missiles, it featured hydropneumatic suspension, adjustable ride height, and advanced fire control systems. It quickly ran into massive cost overruns, technical issues, and disagreements between the partners. Weighing around 47 tons, it was incredibly advanced but too complex and expensive for deployment. The program was cancelled in 1971. The M48 Armor Gun System. The M48 AGS was designed in 1983 as a lightweight replacement for the aging M551 Sheridan. It featured a 105mm gun with an autoloader and modular armor that could be upgraded depending on the mission. Weighing 19 to 25 tons depending on armor configuration, it was designed to be air transportable by C-130 aircraft. The AGS passed tests and was ready for production, but the end of the Cold War led to major defense cuts. Despite being combat ready, the program was cancelled in 1997. The XM-1202 Mounted Combat System. Part of the ambitious future combat system programs in the 2000s, the XM-1202 was a lightweight, network tank concept. It was produced with a 120mm smoothbore gun and designed to operate as a part of digitized, fast-response ground force. Despite being a major technological leap, the program was plagued by cost overruns and shifting military needs. When the FCS program was cancelled in 2009, so too was the XM-1202. It was never completed beyond mock-ups and preliminary testing. With this, the buzz is signing off for today. But we'll see you guys again in our next video. Until then, bye-bye.